Welcome to this Unreal Engine 5.2 tutorial on using splines and meshes for procedural content generation. In this tutorial, we will use these tools to create a fence with multiple components, such as rocks, grass, and flowers. We will then modify the fence by removing parts of it using a mesh actor, creating a navigable passage. First, we will create an actor blueprint for our fence. Open the content browser and navigate to the folder where you want to store the blueprint. Right-click and select Blueprint Class into Actor to create a new blueprint. Name the blueprint BP Fence PAG, and double-click on it to open it in the blueprint editor. Next, we will add the necessary components by clicking the Add Component button and selecting PCG for mesh generation, Spline for defining the fence shape with a spline, and Cube for removing parts of the fence to create a passage. Then let's give our spline a tag named Create Spline so that we can easily identify it later. Click on the spline component to select it, and in the Details panel, scroll down to the Tags section. Click on the plus button to add a new tag and enter Create Spline as the tag name. Next, we need to adjust the shape of the spline to match our desired fence shape. To do this, click on the spline component to select it, and then select one of the spline points. Move the point to adjust the shape of the spline. In this case, we want to make the spline longer by changing the location of one of the points. Then, click on the box component to select it, and in the Details panel, scroll down to the Tags section. Click on the plus button to add a new tag and enter Remove Actor as the tag name. Then, scroll down to the Collision section and set the Collision Enabled property to No Collision. Next, scroll down to the Rendering section and check the Hidden In-Game checkbox to make the box component hidden during gameplay. To generate the fence procedurally, we will use a PCG graph. Let's create a new PCG graph and assign it to the PCG component we added earlier. Right-click in the content browser and select PCG, then PCG graph. Name the graph Fence PCG. With the blueprint open, in the blueprint editor, select the PSG component in the components panel. In the details panel, find the instance section and expand it. Under the graph dropdown, select the spline PCG graph that we just created. With our fence blueprint ready, we can now drag it from the content browser into the world to see the changes. Once we've placed the blueprint, we can open the PCG graph and start editing it to generate the fence mesh procedurally. The first nodes we will add to the PCG graph are Get Actor Data and Filter by Tag. For the tag filter, we will copy the tag we added to the cube earlier, Remove Actor, and paste it into the filter. We will also add a comment to this section of the graph and call it Actor Data to Remove PCG. Next, we will add Get Spline Data and Filter by Tag nodes to the PCG graph. In the tag filter of the Filter by Tag node, we will copy the tag we added to the spline earlier, Create Spline, and paste it into the filter. We will also add a comment to this section of the graph and call it Spline Data to Create PCG. To generate the mesh for our fence, we will use the Spline Sampler node. To the right settings for the node, we will first create a Static Mesh Spawner node and add an array to mesh entries. We will then choose the static mesh that we want to use for our fence and check its dimensions. To check the dimensions, we can locate the mesh in the content browser and hover over it. In our case, the length of the fence is 330 centimeters. Next, in the Spline Sampler node, set the mode setting to distance. Then we can fill in the distance increment setting with the length of our fence. This will ensure that the mesh is generated one after the other according to the size of the fence. Next, we add a difference node and connect the source to the spline sampler node, and the difference to the reroute of the remove actor data, and the output to static mesh spawner node. This allows us to remove the part of the fence where the cube with the remove actor tag is located. When we check the spline in the world, we can see that the fence is generated, but with a part missing at the beginning, because of the actor that removes the data of the PCG. Now, let's rename the cube we added earlier to remove. Then you can modify the cube's scale and location to create the desired size and position for the hole in the fence. If you want to create more holes in the fence, simply duplicate the remove cube by holding down the Alt key and dragging it to a new location. You can then adjust the size and position of the new cube to create another hole in the fence. Now we have a problem when moving the spline, as we'll see that the generated fence mesh is floating in the air. To fix this, we can project the generated mesh onto the landscape. In the PCG graph, we can add a projection node and connect the input to the difference node and the output to the static mesh spawner node. To set up the projection, select our input for the PCG graph, expand it, and drag the landscape onto the projection target parameter. This will ensure that the generated fence mesh is properly placed on the landscape. To change the scale of the fence, we will add a transform points node to the PCG graph. We'll set the absolute scale to true, and set the minimum and maximum scales to 2. However, we'll notice that the fence is overlapping each other. To fix this, we'll need to double the distance increment in the spline sampler node to our new fence size. In our case, that will be 660 centimeters. Next, let's create some rocks under the fence. To do this, we'll first add the Create Grid node and Bound Modifier node to our PCG graph. We'll set the Bound Min and Max to 10 to define the size of our grid. Then we'll add the Copy Points node and connect the target to the Spline Sampler node. To ensure that only the closest points are selected, we'll add the Distance node and Density filter node and adjust the settings to our liking. We can also add the Transform points node and change the offset setting to make the rocks appear a bit more random and not in two straight lines. In the distance node, we will connect the target to the spline sampler node. Then, we can copy and paste the difference node, connect the source to the density filter node, the difference to our remove actor reroute. Next, we will copy and paste the static mesh spawner node and change the mesh to a rock. We will also copy the transform points node from the fence and adjust the values to fit the rock scale. Then, we can copy and paste the projection node and connect all the pins. We can also add more meshes to the array to make the rocks more random. Finally, we will select the static mesh spawner node and search for collision. We will change the collision preset setting to no collision for all the meshes. Great! So now we have our base layer for the rocks, and we can easily create more layers like grass and flowers by simply copying and pasting all the nodes from the first transform points to the last node, static mesh spawner, and changing the settings and meshes as desired. I'll go ahead and create these additional layers, and you can follow along in the video to see how I do it. With all the layers set up, we can now adjust the spline and the remove actor to create our final procedural generated fence. And the best part is that we can easily add or remove holes in the fence just by adjusting the remove actor location or duplicating it. Overall, the PCG approach in Unreal Engine allows for a lot of flexibility and creativity in designing our landscape. And that's it for today's video. We have successfully created a procedural generated fence with multiple layers using Unreal Engine 5.2. I hope this video has been helpful to you in learning how to create your own procedural generated content. Remember, with some creativity, the possibilities are endless. Don't forget to subscribe for more content on game development, and thank you for watching.